Welcome along everybody to Apex Racing TV. My name is Andrew Woodhouse and I'm joined by Adam Bath, and Alex Simpson will be behind the cameras for us tonight. We're here at Laguna Seca for rounds 5 to 8 of the British Sim Racers Touring Car Winter Series, presented by Engine Oil Direct and Adam Bath. And we're here at Laguna Seca, and last week was pretty fun. I wonder what's going to happen this time.
Yeah, last week was pretty crazy to say the least, and I think nothing sums it up more than a driver letting a person buy in and taking them out whilst letting them buy in. I've still got the giggles from that even a week on. But yeah, Laguna Seca, it was great when we were here in the Pro Series last season, and some quite controversial moments there as well, including a race-winning decision by the stewards in race two. So yeah, expecting the same tonight, and another capacity grid, really, another 38 cars. And I can see that Ash Sutton's not here, our championship leader. Jamie Fluke's on the pole, so it looks like he's probably going to get a good shot at taking the championship lead tonight.
Well, yeah, it was race three where Jake Blackhall had victory taken from him and it was given to Colin Cunniff because of a track limits infringement. Alex Simpson, I will bring you in very, very briefly, mate. It's a great turnout for this race, isn't it? 38 cars for essentially a pre-season game.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, awesome turnout, what can you say?
Right then.
Just getting ourselves out of bed, looks like a little glitch on the stream, but over to you guys.
We're almost getting ready for the start then. And there's not going to be long now before the red lights are going to come on. Just a few guys, Adam, just waiting to get on the grid here, and we'll be going in second.
Yeah, it looks like we're still waiting for Dan Hunt to join the grid. Jamie Fluke's the only car on the front row at the moment.
Front row start then for Daniel Hunt, Jamie Fluke on pole, then Dan Hunt, Ben Hackerson, David Baker, Alexander Smolenski, Andreas Katz, George Simmons, Colin Cunniff, Daniel Kraft, Simon Field. That's your top 10 here in the BSRTC Winter Series. Hunt needs to get on the grid pretty sharpish. I think he's only got about 15 seconds left. I'm sure he will get there, but we'll see. No cars starting around the final corner. That's good for them.
Ah, four races, of course, in 10 laps.
Yes, four 10-lap races, of course. The new format. And the red lights are going to come on now.
Green, green, green.
The green light is on at Laguna Seca. Are we going to get a cleaner start than we did in the Pro Series? Let's see. Jamie Fluke got a good getaway, as did Dave Baker. Look at Simon Field trying to go around the outside as he makes it three wide with the friction racing car of Colin Cunniff into the first corner. They go. Alex, is that the sound of crashing I hear?
I think everybody's a little bit of something in the background, but it's not too bad.
Wow.
Oh, there's a few off actually in turn one. There's a few out as well, it looks like. I'm not sure if we can... I'm not sure if you've got a replay of that, mate.
Ooh.
If we can see what went on, it looks like...
Paul Smith.
Rizzo and McColgan and Plumley involved.
The ever unfortunate Paul Smith.
Oh, is he out again?
It looked like he had a bit of a wild moment at turn two. It looks like there's a bit of damage on the car, but he's able to carry on. Jamie Fluke then leading his way up to the corkscrew for the first time, still on cold tyres in these early stages of the race. Ben Hackerson into second and Smolenski into third. So Dan Hunt did not get a good start there, and I thought he picked a slowdown up there at the corkscrew, but he's now coming under pressure from Andreas Katz, the Pro Series runner-up behind him. And then who's that? Then it's George Simmons. Great to see him inside the top 10. He's battling away with Dan Kraft, with David Baker. Sorry, Baker looking to the inside. Down the inside he goes. And at the same time, Kat's trying to get past Hunt as well as we come around to complete lap one.
This is Ben Hackerson's favourite track, and he's making a good fist of it already. He's qualified third, up to second. Oh, Alexander Smolenski's had a good start as well, up to third. And as we head down to turn one, we are actually heading down into turn number one today as Daniel Hunt through on Andreas Katz. So poor start from Hunt, but then he's recovering, and it looks like that's Simmons on the outside trying to go around the outside of Katz, but he's going to run out of road pretty quickly there. Dave Baker just slotting in behind. Pretty clean up the front so far, Adam. I've been quite impressed.
Yeah, those three starting to break away. Hunt and Katz, they've been battling for so long, but they've lost that train, and it's quite a big train in fact forming behind him. Look, we've got Katz, we've got Simmons, Baker, Kraft, Simon Field, Colin Cunniff, Richard Gore, and Pete Newman. So those cars ducked behind in these early stages. We'll see if Katz can try and get a move done up to the corkscrew. We're working our way up the hill now.
Newman
and hard on the brakes.
Newman and Heffert are side by side into the corkscrew. And Heffert's going through, but Newman's going to... Oh, look at that. Nice cutback around the outside, but he's not going to make that stick. He's under pressure now from the Swedish driver, Philip Johansson. Johansson is going to be in the Pro Series in 2016.
And forces it back down the inside, and Newman's having to hang it around the outside. He gets turned.
He's gone.
Who was that? Was that Rob Fagg?
Off goes Johansson.
No, it's Nathaniel Simpson that hits.
It's Simpson's car with horrible damage on the front right-hand side, isn't it?
Just came out of nowhere while those two were going so slowly on the exit of the penultimate corner and just clattered into the side of him there and sent him flying. And
Johansson.
And round the outside goes Rob Fagg, is that? Round the outside he goes. Took a few victories last season. One notable one of Watkins Glen. Tries to get it done there, but there was just no grip on the outside of the Andretti hairpin, and he's now had to concede the place. And who's that now? I'm trying to battle away with it. It's Kip Stevens.
Yeah, Kip Stevens.
Pete Newman's out, by the way.
Two-time champion, multiple race winner, of course. He's trying to get in the action. He's 16th. Overall, right in the middle of this pack, we've actually lost about seven drivers on the first lap. So Lee Berridge is out, Jeroen Kaiser is out, Paul Smith, Michel Protochek is out as well, and John Roberts, Robbie Lindsay, Jason Rowe, and Ethan McCorgan all one lap down or more. Craig McLeod Evans as well, and of course Johansson, who end up in the barrier. Rick Scott, the last man still running, in 28th place.
Nathaniel Simpson's the man on the mission. He was side by side in the corkscrew there with Nick McKerrin. Just couldn't get anything done there. He's going like a man possessed, really, in these opening few laps. He's currently being shown in 14th place. Has left Kip Stevens, really, on this lap and battling away there with what looks like a GT Omega livery car there of Nick McKerrin. And who's that battling away behind?
McKerrin got involved.
No, it's okay. Carry on.
I was going to say McKerrin got involved in some fisticuffs at Brands Hatch, didn't he? And is he going to be overtaken here by Simpson? Or Simpson almost going right across into the green car of McKerrin. And McKerrin did quite well to see that coming, actually.
Andrew Whitehead getting past Dylan Robinson, but not for very much longer, because Robinson's back down the inside. And there's Rob Fagg as well, battling away. So great battles unfolding in the lower region of the top 20 here. Andrew Whitehead, of course, with that orange livery car, now trying to get that round the outside of Dylan Robinson.
Of course, we do have the full reverse grid option as well, which might come into play later on. So some of these guys might be starting quite a decent way up the field. Whitehead with a bit of damage on that car. Oh, look at that. Oh, it's very difficult to go too wide, Adam, through that. Very fast left-hander, and now actually it looks like Robert Fagg's going to get the move done. Is he into the corkscrew? Whitehead's late on the brakes. Is he too late on the brakes? No, Fagg's got a great exit.
He's going to try and go around the outside. I think that's a problem for Colin Cunniff, because he's just tumbling down the timing screen all of a sudden. Surely no way around the outside there for Rob Fagg.
And good now, attempt.
Yeah, good attempt there, but just unfortunately no room. And now he's going to come under pressure from Julian Janowski. Janowski there with a very good livery. Oh, and Andrew Whitehead down the inside hits Dylan Robinson. Goes off, and that's going to ruin Whitehead's pace, and that's going to allow Rob Fagg through.
An incident here would ruin people's race, as Robinson, having got whacked up the rear end into the final corner, now under pressure from Rob Fagg in the Eurochip Digital car. And then on the back of this group, you've got Plumley, Richardson, and Bond, it looks like. I don't know if the Powermax car's rocking slightly different livery, I think, for this one. Different mirrors.
Those are Powermax cars getting drawn in. New Home Digital car, sorry, and Colin Cunniff looks like he had a technical problem with his system. That's why he's now out of the race. He's back here, though, in the pits. And yeah, this battle continues to unfold. And for Julian Janowski there, about to come under pressure from, who's that behind? Laura Bond and the New Home Digital car. And off goes Robinson. He went into the gravel through the left-hander kink, and that's going to allow Rob Fagg to swoop round the outside into the corkscrew. Is he going to make the corner? Just.
Yes, he gets it done, Robert Fagg, so that's nice. And you've really got to get that slingshot down the hill out of the corkscrew through this beautiful section, which I really like a lot. Really nice cambered corners, give you a lot of confidence in the car, and you can really see if your car's working well through there into the last corner. Quite a tight one.
Get hit by the car behind, and that is Jay Wright. And luckily there, she didn't go into the back of Janowski, otherwise that would have been rather messy indeed.
Max Wright is not that far behind as well, a few places behind Jay. Flying last week, hopefully not this week. So the gap is only 3/10, Adam, at the front.
Yes, it is. And Ben Hackerson, you were saying Laguna Seca is his favourite racetrack, and he seems to be keeping in check with Jamie Fluke. Lap times last time around, Jamie Fluke 1:26.3, Ben Hackerson 1:25.8. So just half a second there between them, and we're going to get four laps to go when we get to the line. So we'll see what the lap times are like between these two this time around. And of course, there are other battles continuing inside the top 10, as here comes Andreas Katz down the inside of Dan Hunt. This is a change for fourth position. We'll see if Hunt can get a run on the outside line.
That's going to allow Simmons possibly a way into the battle as well. Over the line they go, and Katz and Hunt and Simmons. Who's going to be the bravest one here? Oh, look at that. Josh Simmons and Dan Hunt banging panels. Hunt's going to have the inside. Oh, again. After that it goes. And Simmons had the room on the outside, but it's always difficult, Adam, when the car on the inside can just place it where he wants to.
Yeah, and the corners here on this infield section at the beginning of the lap really suit the inside line there, so it's really hard to get a move done around the outside, and really that section really designed for the motorbikes, really.
Yeah, what I was going to say is that, you know, you can overtake here at Laguna Seca, but you have to be very brave. You have to really make a decisive move, and I wonder if there's going to be a decisive move from either George Simmons, Dave Baker, or Dan Kraft, because they're battling over fifth place behind Neil Hunt.
Great racing in this first race then of the evening. Great moves, including that one by Rob Fagg into the corkscrew. We'll see if George Simmons can get it done on Dan Hunt. He's got a good run off the penultimate corner. Hunt covers the inside line, and Simmons is going to try and get the cut back in. Look how close David Baker is as well. He wants to get that sixth place that he's all too famous for.
Yes.
Coming across the line, three laps to go.
Yeah, and he may get it as well as we head towards getting the first corner, double apex left-hander. Tightening as well. Baker just positioning his car on the inside to just ward off a move from Daniel Kraft. Got Alex Simpson doing the cameras for us today. Alex, what are you seeing out there, mate? What do you think is going to transpire at the front?
I'll be honest, mate, I'm not seeing anything right now. Trying to sort out some major technical issues with YouTube that are stopping it going out live.
Alright, well, that's just fine and dandy then, isn't it? Adam, we always have that one technical problem, I think.
Yeah, good to get it out of the way in the Winter Series and pre-season friendly and all that. And yeah, there's some battles. That battle inside in the lower regions of the top 20 continuing. Rob Fagg and Dylan Robinson were side by side as they came across the line, as were Whitehead and Janowski, but they all sought each other out through this middle part of the lap. Nick McCarron and Pete Newman there. And who's that battling with? It's Rob Plumley and Jay Wright. Those two are side by side now as we head up to this top of the hill, this left-hand kink. Who's going to have the position? Rob Plumley's going to try and hang it out around the outside as he just gets forced out wide. And those two New Homes Digital cars watching eagerly to see what's going to happen as we head up to the corkscrew.
I'm having a seizure looking at Plumley's car. All sorts of different... It's got the Muppets on it, though. And, is he going to make a Muppet out of Jay Wright? Well, we're going to find out in a second, because that lime green machine blows it off, goes Richardson. And he was pushing it a little bit there. It was Laura Bond, actually, that went off, wasn't it? So they've switched positions, but not very helpful from Powermax, actually. Those two cars have the same colour mirrors this time.
Other battles going on inside the top 10. They were changing a bit during the last lap. Dan Hunt's lost a few positions. He's now down into 7th place. So Baker and Kraft have both got through.
Yeah, and I wonder where that actually happened. We didn't see it on the screen. Let's have a quick... Oh, it was over. Did he get a bad run out of the last corner? Oh, yeah, he did. He went wide at the last corner on the exit, and that's where they all got through. But actually, Simmons, who was second in the queue. So the front two have been replaced by the two behind.
Our last corner, it seems to be Dan Hunter-Killies here, who got overtaken there by Andreas Katz a few laps ago and struggled there last time around and then obviously lost the place.
Simmons, if he's let Simmons through there or whether he's struggling with damage, I think he's got damage, Dan Hunt.
So yeah, must have either a problem or he picks up a slowdown and it's going to... Is the car crabbing at all? I can't really tell. And Dan, and now Salmon Field's now going to try and have a go. And then there's a rarity there. There's an Apex Racing TV car of Richard Gore.
Yes. It doesn't look that bad, Adam, to be honest. Dan Hunt's car, I think he's back up to full speed now. He must have had a slowdown. Must have cut the course somewhere. Of course, we have to remind you that iRacing does provide you with a penalty system. If you are deemed to have cut the course, gained an advantage, you have to give that time back.
So we are last lap then.
Yes, and Jamie Fluke leads by 1.3. So as the race has gone on, you see the Irishman just extending that slightly, Adam. It's been impressive from Jamie Fluke. He's really actually showed quite a big improvement in pace in the Kia Optima recently.
Yes, indeed. Oh, Field and Hunt rubbing each other up, and Field is through, and we'll see Richard Gore could try and get through. Yeah, but yeah, Jamie Fluke. Ben Hackerson was only 0.3 seconds behind him for a good 2/3 of the race, but then all of a sudden, Hunt's off again, and Kraft's about to try and get past David Baker, as we head to the top of the corkscrew. No way through there, I don't think. But yeah, Jamie Fluke, second in the championship going into this race meeting. No Ash Sutton.
He's just taken the lead, hasn't he?
So yeah, it looks like through the final corner, he's going to take a victory here in race one of Laguna Seca and most likely take the championship lead.
Yes, Jamie Fluke then comes across and dominates the first race here at Laguna Seca. Brilliant effort in front of Ben Hackerson, who, has to be said, he's going to be a threat when he steps up from the Kia Club Series at some point. And then Alexander Smolenski, Andreas Katz, third and fourth, Baker in fifth, Dan Kraft sixth, seventh for George Simmons. And then Daniel Hunt in the end was eighth, with Simon Field and Richard Gore rounding out the top ten. So very interesting race, really, Adam. I mean, it showed how it's hard to overtake round here when you're evenly matched, but, you know, you may have to use a bit of force to get your way.
Yeah, it was almost controlled chaos that first race, because there were a few bits of contact, but it all seemed pretty normal, pretty typical touring car racing, really. And yeah, we'll see how it develops through the other three races tonight. Of course, a four-race meeting format being tested out here in the Winter Series. We're only through the rest of the finishes then. Steve Hefford finished 11th, 12th, 6 seconds behind was Nathaniel Simpson, then Kip Stevens in 13th, 14th Dylan Robinson, 15th Rob Fagg, 16th Julian Janowski, 17th Andrew Whitehead, 18th Nick McCarron, 19th Jay Wright and Rob Plumley in 20th, 21st Laura Bond, 22nd is Steve Richardson, 23rd it is Max Wright, 24th it's Robert Graham, 25th Cesar Rizzo, 26th the last of the normal reverse grid positions is Rick Scott, and then the car's one lap down or more. 27th, Pete Newman, 28th, Colin Cunniff, 29th, Jerome Kaiser, 30th, Sean Roberts, 31st, Jason Rowe, 32nd, Craig McLeod Evans, 33rd, Philip Johansson, 34th, Lee Berridge, 35th, the ever unfortunate Paul Smith, 36th, Mikhail Potacek, 37th, Robbie Lindsay, and then 38th, it is Ethan McColgan.
Yeah, well done again. 38 cars to read out. We didn't think we'd have such big grids in this Winter Series, to be honest, but we are very, very happy indeed with that. Alex, have we sorted the technical issues out then?
Nope.
So that's enough for race one here at Laguna Seca, but we'll be back. We've got three more races left for tonight, and we'll be back here on Apex Racing TV and Motors TV after this break. Welcome back to Motors TV and round 6 of the British Sim Racers Touring Car Winter Series, brought to you by Apex Racing TV and Engine Oils Direct. My name is Andrew Woodhouse and I'm joined again by Adam Bath and Alex Simpson on cameras. And Adam, the first race was won by Jamie Fluke in fine style. He's going to have a job on to fight through from what will be 16th place in this one.
Yeah, 16 cars reversed for the second race of the evening. And yeah, Jamie Fluke, he had to withstand some pressure from Ben Hackerson in the early going of the race, but yeah, in the end managed to take a convincing victory, really. Nearly 2 seconds, I think, his win was at the end. But some very decent battles going on throughout the pack, really, inside the top 10 and below. I think we can expect the same. A bit hairy at the start, a few collisions there, but that's nothing really that we haven't seen in the season.
Yeah, there are many drivers who did come to grief at the start. There were about 10 retirements on the first lap, so we hope that that does not happen again. And we hope we have a clean race here in Monterey, California, USA. Laguna Seca Circuit, historic track. It's hosted many, many races, including sports cars and, of course, possibly most notably, MotoGP, United States Grand Prix in recent years. And Adam, some memorable moments in that one as well. I remember a couple of incidents of the corkscrew that would be pretty phenomenal.
Oh yeah, 2008 was a race between Casey Stoner and Valentino Rossi. Of course, that champ car race in 96, I think, Zanardi down the inside going into the corkscrew. So some brilliant races here. And yeah, in sports cars as well. So Janowski there on the pole, Fag second, Dylan Robinson third, Stevens fourth, Nathaniel Simpson in fifth, Steve Efford sixth, Richard Gore in seventh, Simon Field in eighth, Dan Hunt in ninth. And then George Simmons rounds out the top 10. A look at the standings quickly as well. Jamie Fluke leads that. Smolenski is in second and Hackerson is in third position.
Thank you very much. So two regulars on the front row and then a two-time champion on the second. Let's see what's going to happen now. Can Janowski get away? Well, this time he was on pole at Daytona. It didn't work for him, but the green light comes on now and he gets away decently. Julian Janowski. Good start. He covers the inside line immediately so that Rob Fagg can't get any purchase and can't get a chance to throw the gear up to run up the inside. Dylan Robinson is going through. Is he going to throw both of them into the first corner? No, he doesn't. He runs a little bit wide. Oh my goodness. Oh, out. Kim Stevens is out. And I think that was a couple of other ones as well, possibly James Leggett.
They all managed to get themselves off the circuit. Nathaniel Simpson as well. And look, apart from that, looks like everyone's safe. Who's that off? I think that's George Simmons, the car with the pink at the back of the car. Yeah, he's hanging it out. He was all over the place going through that short straight towards turn four. Heading our way down the inside now. I hear more contacts. Everyone looks like they're sorting each other out, but very, very tight in these early few corners.
Yeah, bit of a crazy start there.
Fag through, into the lead, past Janowski. Through that left-hand kink, and now Janowski might be under pressure from Dylan Robinson up to the corkscrew.
It was Nathaniel.
He takes out Fag.
Oh!
And they're coming back onto the track.
The leaders.
Gore.
Oh, there's Gore, and this could be pretty big. Oh, no.
And off goes Kraft. Kraft into the concrete wall on the exit of the corkscrew. I don't know what happened there. Oh. That was a secondary incident.
Safety car then. But, all sorts of incidents going on. So Janowski's out, Robert Fagg. Oh, Rob Fagg down the inside of Daniel Hunt, and that's a really good pass there. If he could make it stick, but I don't think he has. As Dan Hunt, Rob Fagg's got damage, I'm sure, Adam.
I'm amazed how Rob Fagg's managed to continue, yeah.
Yeah, that collision with Janowski's car looks reasonably clean. A bit of rear right damage, actually, I am honestly not sure how he's still in the race, but he's got Andreas Katz, that his Pro Series teammate, behind him. Of course, no teams, no friends in this BSR Kia Winter Series, of course. And Ben Hackerson up to 9th already. Jamie Fluke up to 10th. So the two men who finished first and second have managed to get up there. And Alex, that was a bit crazy in the first lap.
Yeah, not sure what to say about that. Just missed the breaking point by an absolute mile, Janowski there, and just caused all that, unfortunately. So yeah, doesn't deserve to be in the race. Wiped out a lot of people there, and simple little miss of the brakes.
Field and Baker battling away. Baker down the inside, the Eurochip digital car into the corkscrew. That's how you get a move done there. Yeah. Julian Janowski, and he is through into what is 7th position. Nick McKerrin and Rob Plumley battling away as well.
Baker's one away from where he needs to be, of course. And, two places away from where he needs to be in that 6th place. Paul Smith still going. I'm sure I've just cursed it because he's now in a battle with Newman.
George Simmons has just vanished. He's now dropping down the timing screen like a stone. He was in second place.
He flashed back for a second, but yeah, he's got some problems with his connection. He was jumping all over the place when I saw it. Sorry, Andrew, for jumping in.
It's all right. You jump in whenever you like, mate.
He's back now. At the same time, Hunt and Hefford battling.
Yeah, indeed. And Hefford's very quietly managed to make his way up to third place, although it might be fourth now as Dan Hunt then. Round the outside into turn four. Oh, this isn't going to be good at all. Oh, no.
Are they going to stop the car? Yes, just. They both slam on the brakes.
Oh,
and
dear.
I think one engine's gone. I think that's probably Dan Hunt. And yeah, both of them are out as well. So yeah, that didn't end too well.
We're going through quickly tonight, Adam. I tell you, there'll be no one left. This race.
We lost half the field at Brands Hatch in race four. Another crowd off. That is Ben Hackerson. So just as you were saying he was on the move, he's out. He was in ninth place at the top of the hill.
It's really a good job there's no money at stake, isn't it? Otherwise, it's Robert Fagg again. Robert Fagg has not enjoyed that section of the course today. Plumley almost going off, trying to avoid Rob Fagg there.
It was Rob Fagg and Ben Hackerson, that's what happened, up the top of the hill. And
it looks like they just got stuck together again.
Yeah. Rob Fagg limping back to the pits. And now Simmons leads.
Alex, we see that a lot, don't we? The cars just seem to get sucked together and, you know, big accidents happen, especially at the top of that hill.
I think it's the second most likely event to happen from a, from the quarter panel, isn't it, really? So
the quarter panel's still involved, except it happens at the end.
Yeah. So, we see it time and time again, and what do you think that is? I don't know if the guys have got like single screens or triples, just, you know, they just get a bit close and then that's it. The sim does the rest.
And it might be when they actually do get close and actually make contact from being on the single screen, you have to move away instantly, and it seems like quite a lot of them aren't really doing a good enough job of trying to actually get out of the way. But that remains to be seen. Paul Smith, incidentally, again, if anything bad happens to him in any of the races, I think this season, I think it'll be my fault, but... Ooh. Oh, there we go!
Hits Plumley.
Well, that's the end of Plumley, is it? Now is he back on?
And a New Homes Digital car, Steve Richardson, I think he's got a slowdown. Plumley having a slowdown as well, so he has to let Paul Smith through. And who's that behind? Is that John Roberts?
I was going to say that... I think it is John Roberts. It is. And I was going to say that Paul's gone from 35th up to 13th, and then he proceeds to hit...
Whoa!
Whack someone off the course. That, there we go. And it's now Steve Richardson that he's trying to get past as well. Oh, is it Laura Bond? It's Laura Bond. They've got the same car, same looking car. Down the inside goes Smith, and that's a strong move there.
So Smith into 12th position, and the next car on his list will be Pete Newman in 11th there, who's battling with Jerome Kaiser, who's now in 10th place. Where did he start? He started in 29th, so we've got a whole load of cars coming back through the pack, and it's actually right ahead there.
Looks like a clean car for the Dutchman as well, which is almost a miracle in itself, as Whitehead gets that one completely wrong in front of him. McCarron's had a great race. Nick McCarron up to 8th place from 18th on the grid. He's not got involved in any of that silliness. Whitehead's off, is he? He's been struggling.
And that's going to allow Kaiser through. And will Newman try and get through as well up to the corkscrew late on the brakes? And he hits Kaiser.
Oh, those two have hit each other as well.
And here comes Newman down the inside.
And round the outside. Slingshot, like the roller coaster down the hill.
Maybe back down the inside into that corner. Will he have the speed, though?
Well, he may have to. Yeah, I think he will now. He'll have to carry this, though, because... Oh, Whitehead's got a nice run. Is he going to go up the inside into the final corner? It's an overtaking. It's an overtaking manoeuvre and possibility. And excuse me, says Pete Newman, as he rams into the back of Jerome Kaiser's car. And there's a bit going on behind as well, look. It's Lee Berridge, Plumley. And then a bit further back, you've got... that's Max Wright and the yellow car of Robbie Lindsay. Right down the inside, Adam.
Yes, indeed. And with the battles as well. Yeah, and Max right there, yeah, battling away with Lindsay, and those two battling over 21st and 22nd. Other battles here, Rob Plumley still under pressure. He's down the inside of Lee Berridge in the Eurochip Digital car. And who's that behind? That is Michael Pozacek up to the left-hander here. About to go up the hill. Berridge down the inside. Is he going to make the corner? Is he going to have a poor exit? Oh, Robert Plumley's closing in, definitely.
It's not bad, I must admit. Good opportunity there. Oh, yeah. There he goes.
And it's shoving it down the inside goes Pozacek there. We'll see if he's got a run. Up to the top of the hill. Plumley's trying to find some space. They're all going to check up here.
Oh, I tell you. And that's good opportunistic driving from Steve Richardson, because Pozacek was asleep there in the corkscrew.
And Kaiser and Newman battling. Kaiser, those two positions changed. Whoa, Whitehead and Newman, those two are hitting each other into the final corner. They're both fighting over the same bit of track, and that's going to allow Paul Smith and Laura Bond to close in if they're not too careful. Over the line they go, onto lap number six now.
Yeah, Smith having a decent race. And at the front, George Simmons has a 2.5 second lead over Andreas Katz, so... Let's have a look at the lap times. Last time around, Simmons did a 26.5, Katz did a 27.0. George Simmons looking like he's got the beating of the two-time champion at the moment, but we'll see if Katz can come back. There's not a lot of time left. Only four laps. 3.5 laps. Oh, Simmons wide, and the gravel gets spat out there from the back of that Kia Optima.
Needs to be a bit careful. Field and Jamie Fluke battling here. And Fluke down the inside, over the top of the hill, into the corkscrew. Fields late on the brakes as well. He should just be able to hold on. Yeah, Simon Field still in fifth position, with Fluke in sixth.
Good race from Jamie Fluke. We said he would have a job to come through to win the race, Adam, and that's proved to be true. But what he does need to do is he needs to rack up some consistent points and get some finishes inside the top 10, possibly even the top 5 if he can now, as Field gets a slowdown, I'm sure. Is that right? Yeah, there he goes, look. So, he'll cut the course there, and Jamie Fluke takes advantage up into the top 5. And like I say, Adam, this is what he really needs for his championship.
Yeah, he's got the championship lead for now, and he needs to do what Wojciech Savidovic was able to do in the regular season, last season in the Pro Series, just consistent finishes, really. And unfortunately, that didn't work out for Savidovic in the end, in the showdown, of course, with the points being so close. But yeah, that was definitely one to look at. If you looked at the Pro Series last season, David Baker has just got past Dylan Robinson, so he's now into third position, with Fluke now in fifth, Newman sixth, seventh, Smolensky eighth, Nick McCarron ninth, Sharon Kaiser tenth, Whitehead. Smith still not able to shake off John Roberts, who was the Pro-Am Series champion last season. Paul Smith was right there to the very end. Of course, had so many crashes in the showdown, he wasn't able to get it done. But yeah, these two battling away now.
And he was disappointed with that, because such a strong regular season. And battle has well and truly been joined between Nick McCarron and Jeroen Kaiser then. So, England versus Holland. And McCarron will be hoping it's more like Euro 96.
Oh, Smith and McCarron and Roberts battling, at the corkscrew. But yeah, McCarron and Kaiser still battling.
And Johansson and,
they hit it, a bit of contact there between Smith.
Smith. And then Johansson trying to get through. Has he got room? Roberts leaves the door.
He gets
open.
It.
And,
was that Bond? Yeah, it was Laura Bond.
Well, Plumley's going to lose a position to Berridge. Berridge might try around the outside of both of them. Is Berridge going to have Johansson here? Oh, off goes Smith.
Yeah, very interesting line there by Paul Smith. I think he just put foot to the floor mid-corner and managed to hold on. We'll see if Roberts can get the speed, though, over the top of the hill through that left-hander. Hard on the brakes into turn one. He leaves the space, but no way through.
John Roberts, the AM champion, then walked away with $500 last season. Oh, and he got a great exit from the second corner, Adam, and surprising considering he had the tighter line, but Roberts looks like his tyres are in better shape at this point.
Yeah, Smith having to do some very good defensive driving here through the right-hander. Now onto this short straight towards the left-hander, where Jorge Lorenzo had a huge incident back in MotoGP a few years ago. Here we go, round the outside goes John Roberts.
That. Oh, he's on the marbles, though.
Oh, he's off.
Got right on the marbles there at this point in the race. Of course, as the race meeting goes on, you'll see the marbles developing on the outside line.
somehow able to rejoin in front of Bond and Johansson.
So yeah, the marbles get kicked off these tyres just like in real life, and that's a newish feature that iRacing's put in. And very realistic, Adam, you don't want to run off the racing line because you will struggle for grip.
Yeah, and this track in real life is notorious for being extremely dusty as well. And yeah, obviously we saw there. And down the inside goes Roberts on Johansson. Those two are going to be side by side as we get to the final corner, and Plumlee's going to join in as well. Plumlee, who has had his fair share of knocks so far tonight, through the final corner onto what is going to be the final lap of the race.
Robert's got a good exit. I don't know how he did, because he was all over the AstroTurf on the outside that final corner. But yeah, he's going to put Philip Johansson under pressure. So they head down to turn one yet again, this time for the final time. And Johansson survives the two new Holmes Digital cars. And look at that. Look at that move by Richardson. He's going to try and go around the outside of Berridge. Oh, and is he going to make it? He's carrying great speed, Steve Richardson.
Hit that red sausage curb there.
Yeah, but look at that, he's got the traction. Again, the tyres. It's Laura Pond, actually, isn't it? It's not Steve Richardson, I thought. Again, I'm getting confused with the cars.
Up to the left-hand and up the hill for the final time. Berridge, I don't think, got the best run out of there. Not really. So Dylan Robinson's dropping positions. Something's happened up at the front. And he's off, that's why.
Through the final corner comes George Simmons. And George Simmons is going to take his first win in BSR Touring cars. There he goes, by 2.6 seconds, and that was brilliantly deserved by him, ahead of two drivers who have won three titles between them and been runner-up twice as well.
Yeah, Katz in second and Baker in third, everyone just filtering through now, across the line goes Mick McCarron in eighth, Kaiser in ninth, Pete Newman there. Here comes Paul Smith, he's going to finish ahead of Johansson. And it looks like Richardson's going to finish just ahead of Berridge. That's going to be a drag race to the line.
Bond. It's Bond, yeah. Oh! That was Berridge that got that.
That was interesting there. It looked like that Berridge just got the better exit, because Bond was quite comfortably ahead, it looked like, right to the very end.
Yeah, and Kip Stevens just behind them in 18th. Started fourth, was involved in the melee at the first corner, but then he managed to persevere and head up to fourth place. So an excellent job by Kip Stevens. Right then, so Adam, if you would take us through the top 20.
But yeah, George Simmons then taking his first victory in the BSR TC, from 10th on the grid to first. Second is Andreas Katz, third David Baker, and we'll get to my favourite stat in a minute. Fourth, Simon Field. Fifth, Jamie Fluke. Sixth, Alex Malensky. Seventh, Dylan Robinson. Eighth, Nick McCarron. Ninth, Jerome Kaiser. And in 10th, Andrew Whitehead. 11th, Pete Newman. 12th, Paul Smith, from 35th on the grid. 13th, from 33rd, Philip Johansson. 14th is John Roberts. 15th, Rob Plumlee. 16th is Lee Berridge. 17th, Laura Bond. 18th, Kip Stevens. 19th, Steve Richardson. Max Wright in 20th. 21st is Dan Hunt. 22nd, Robert Graham. 23rd was Craig McLeod Evans. 24th, Robbie Lindsay. 25th, Mikhail Potoshek. 26th, Rick Scott. 27th, Jason Rowe. And then the cars one lap down or more, as there seems to be a huge wreck going on the straight up towards the corkscrew. Ben Hackerson, 28th. Rob Fagg, 29th. 30th, Steve Hefford. 31st, Dan Hunt. 32nd, Julian Janowski, the pole sitter. 33rd, Nathaniel Simpson. 34th, Richard Gore. 35th, Jay Wright. 36th, Cesar Rizzo. And then 37th, Colin Cunniff, who didn't have a good start at all down at the Andretti hairpin. And yeah, my favourite stat, cars that finished inside, that started inside the top 10, that finished inside the top 10, only two in this one, and that was Dylan Robinson that started third and finished seventh, and Simon Field that started eighth and finished fourth.
All right, excellent. All right, Alex, we'll go to the reverse grid then.
Yeah, let's get it done. Bring up the wheel. Try and big it up a little bit more this time compared to the last after all the little issues.
15 down to 26 then. Plumlee, Berridge, Bond, Stevens, Richardson, Wright, Kraft, Graham. Scroll down the screen. McLeod, Evans, Lindsay, Potoshek, and Rick Scott. Or we have a full reverse grid, so who's it going to be?
Here we go then. Second time tonight. We missed the full by quite a way. 23, could be 19. Yes, it is. 19th.
Steve Richardson then is on pole position for the third race of the evening. Kip Stevens second, Laura Bond third, Lee Berridge fourth, and Rob Plumley in fifth. So with a Power Max New Homes Digital freezer there, right at the top of the top of the grid.
Oh, so who's that, Sonny? Who's that?
Richardson, Stevens, and Bond.
Richardson, Stevens, and Bond. Right, cool. Right then, everyone, thanks for joining us here again on Motors TV for race two of the evening on the BSRTC Winter Series. We're going to be back after this break for race three from Laguna Seca. Welcome to round 7 of the British Sim Racers Touring Car Winter Series from Laguna Seca in California. My name is Andrew Woodhouse, and once again, Adam Bath is with me in the commentary box. And Adam, it looks like Steve Richardson on pole position.
Yeah, 19 cars reversed for this third race of the evening. I nearly said third and final. We'll get out of that habit. He's on the pole position. Stevens is in second, Laura Bond third, Berridge fourth, Plumley in fifth, Roberts sixth, Johansson seventh, eighth. Is Paul Smith, yeah, I was looking at the right ninth, Pete Newman, and in 10th it is Andrew Whitehead. And with the battles that we saw going around those positions, those drivers in race 2, this should mean that we're in for a very exciting race 3 at the front of the pack. We'll update you on the championship standings as well. Jamie Fluke continues to lead Alex Smolenski by 36 points, and 69's point back is Kip Stevens, and then Katz in 4th. And Simon Field in 5th. So two more races to go tonight. Let's see what happens in this one.
All right, Power Max 1 and 3 then. 1, 2 and 3 with Kip Stevens alongside Steve Richardson. So all the league admins are at the front. There's going to be madness, I'm sure. Richardson gets away well. Green flag flies. Oh, and look at that from Berridge. Great start from the second row. He's monstering Kip Stevens into turn one. Oh, there's a crash. There's a big crash in the middle. Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. I think that's Simmons flying everywhere. I could just see a pink car. Oh, Stevens in second place. Oh, they're all off again. Roberts off and Laser Tools car off. Kaiser's trying to get through. Paul Smith's through as well. But yeah, it's still Power Max 1, 2, 3, but Bond is through into second place now. Steve Richardson continues to lead. She might have a go at Steve Richardson, in fact, going into the left-hander. Stevens has a look down the inside. Then it's Plumley. Then it's Johansson with Berridge in there as well. And look at Berridge all over the back of Robert Plumley. He might have given a bit of contact there, and I think it's because Plumley has either got a problem or a slowdown.
Now, the key thing for Power Max is that they don't take each other off. They have a history in this team. Elite Martini, even Power Max themselves. Yeah, they've had a history of running into each other. Remember Lime Rock Park, and also the race at the back end of last season, Adam, where they clashed.
Yeah, this history does go far back to season 7, I think, was when Smolenski was racing for them as well. Yeah, so.
Oh, that's off for John Roberts. Again. Oh, he spun back into the way.
Oh, my word.
And how David Baker avoided disaster there is beyond me.
It looks like he might be in a bit of trouble with Nick McCarron, because McCarron's off as well, and oh my word, a car flying off.
Who was that? I don't even know who that was.
It was Cesar Rizzo. He just appeared out of nowhere. It's like...
Rizzo is gone. He's toast.
And
he's...
we also lost the championship leader as well in that sort of turn one crash.
We lost Simmons, who won the last race. We lost Jamie Fluke. We lost John Roberts, the AMP champion.
He must have had some connection problems, because he's not showing up on my screen at all and just appears flying through the air.
We lost Rick Scott.
Three wide around Newman, Berridge, Kaiser, all them.
Did Berridge make some contact there with Smith? Not sure, because he dropped back and Smith under pressure from Kaiser. So it's Richardson, Bond, Stevens, Berridge, Johansson. So Johansson is Johansson's fourth behind Stevens. Stevens trying to play the rear gunner for his teammates. Philip Johansson there, Kia Club Series driver. I've raced against him on Sunday nights. He's very, very good indeed. And he's through on Kip Stevens. That's beautiful.
And now Pete Newman's going to try and get a bit of the action. He goes down the inside and looks like a problem for Jerome Kaiser. Kaiser's Meyer picked up a slowdown because he's now dropped down to 12th.
Stevens has got the chance to get that position back on Newman. He's going to cut him back. Oh, look at that. That's wonderful. A fantastic move by Kip Stevens. Judge that to absolute perfection. That's really hard to do in sim racing.
Ooh. Yeah, indeed. And he's like, look at this behind. Out of the way. Kraft and Berridge. Kraft just lunged it down the inside.
Oh, Cunniff, is it? Cunniff into the wall at the last corner. To the pit wall. Alex, I don't know if you saw that. Was that another... someone just gave him a tap?
Just have a look it back on replay now, actually.
Oh, see, he breaks on the grass.
See what it is.
Oh. Dear.
Oh, we know what's coming then. Let's just keep an eye out for it. So, yeah, he got a good run, didn't he? On the, do you know what? There was a little jink, and he tried to avoid, and then yeah, the braking on the gravel just spat him out the other way, and that's that.
Is that for Colin Cunniff? He's out. Laura Bond's gone into the lead then, and she's actually making quite a good headway ahead of Steve Richardson. So Bond, who's never won a British Sim Racer Touring Car race, he's in a very good position to do so at the moment. After three laps, of course, Paul Smith attacking Pete Newman and in the corkscrew. And Newman still attacking Kip Stevens. They've had a good battle so far. As Smolenski's disposed of Berridge, and he's going to be off after Andreas Katz, who's been fairly quiet, Adam.
Off goes Richardson.
That's not quiet at all. Stevens is gone. Oh no, it's Richardson. It was Richardson.
And Johansson's through into second position. It was just contact. They got stuck together again on the exit of the second to last corner, and that's what spun out Steve Richardson. Johansson, though, I think he's on a mission. He's into second place now.
Johansson went. You can't accuse him of not going. Oh, Stevens missing his breaking point there.
And that's going to allow Newman through. He's down the inside, but Stevens should hang it out around the outside. Smith might try and get involved now as we head down towards this right-hander.
Stevens with what I assume actually could be the new Powermax livery for 2016. We don't actually know. It's a bit of a changed colour scheme for him.
And, very similar to Johansson Smith as well.
Yeah, and Johansson rocking that 1999 Honda Civic light touring car.
Newman basically hit Stevens. And Smith's got a problem because he's now all of a sudden slowing down. I don't know what happened to him. I'll have to try to have a look back at that.
All sorts of rubbish going on there. And I tell you what, it's going to continue up towards the corkscrew as well. Smith's got damage on the front of his car. Baker's looking in there. So is Stevens.
Over the top.
Baker's down the inside. Word. And does he manage to get it done? He does indeed. So Dave Baker with a good move there. Richard Gore, he's also on the back of this pack to 12th. Alex, absolute craziness out there.
It's great. It's what we want to see.
This driver's not messing about in the Winter Series, Adam, I'll tell you now.
Yeah,
no money at stake, of course.
And this is just a prelude for the full series, and I think we're going to be in for some great racing. And now Baker's going to try and get past Newman. As we're coming across the line. Yeah, it's almost like race four at Brands Hatch again. Down the inside, no way through there for Baker. Smith and side by side, who's that? That's Dylan Robinson trying to get past trying to get past Robinson. No way through there in the first corner. Poor Paul Smith is now down to 11th place.
I did think that, actually, Adam, it's about race four at Brands Hatch, but this is only race three, so heaven knows what we're going to get in race four. I think if we'll hit that full reverse grid button as off goes. I can't even see for the smoke. It's Potter shape. And Alex, can you rig that wheel so that it comes up full?
I can try my best.
Just replace the Richard Gore button with the full button.
Well, no one can see us do it, so yeah. I can just say it's full, can't I?
Nathaniel Simpson, well off the track there. He's lost three positions. One to Ben Hackerson, one to Yuli Janowski, and another to Jeroen Kaiser. As Hackerson having a look down the inside of Janowski into the corkscrew. He can't quite do it, though, in that Team I glazing car.
And of course Ben Hackerson, who was second in race one, and now to battle his way back through.
Of course you can see Ben Hackerson in the BSR Kia Club Series with Paul Smith and Dan Blake, of course, two veterans of the BSR TC Pro Series. That's every Sunday night here on Apex Racing TV.
Philip Johansson's not making too much inroads into Laura Bond. The gap's 2.1 seconds as they came across the line. We've just reached the halfway point of the race, and Laura Bond at the moment is on course to possibly take her first victory in the BSRTC. Richard Gorn, Dylan Robinson battling. Those two positions have changed. Heading down to turn two, Richard Gorn, the Apex Racing TV car. And also just in front of them, David Baker and Lee Berridge battling away as well. That's for 9th and 10th.
Now, do these stats, Adam, actually count for the career stats of the drivers in this winter series? Because is this unofficially season 10, or is it...
Yeah.
Do we know if these count? Yeah. Will this be officially Laura Bond's first win if she does take it?
I don't see any reason why it shouldn't count.
It's just a normal. It's just another BSR series, isn't it? Yep. Doesn't matter. It's the winter one.
Smith and Gore up to the top of the hill. They look extremely close. Paul Smith lays on the brakes, nearly hits David Baker.
Oh, Paul. He's gone off.
He's back before he was disqualified there.
I did as well, because he disappeared. He's back on. He's having all sorts of problems with handling that Kia Optima.
I think his computer just decided to disconnect him out of fright of him hitting the back of David Baker, but he's back now, side by side with Steve Hefford.
Oh, off course, want to check.
And down the inside goes Dylan Robinson. And off in front of them is Lee Berridge. He's back on in front of Baker. So many battles to watch down this front straight. The Apex Racing TV car of Richard Gore battling away with Robinson.
Hefford and
Smith, three wide Bank. Nearly.
Hefford and Rob Fagg there.
Oh, Smith
it's
hits
gonna,
him.
Oh, no!
Oh, he takes them both off.
Take that, he says. Oh, no, that's what happens when a man from Yorkshire gets overexcited.
And Robbie Lindsay nearly gets involved. And who's that green guy? Is that Nick McCarron? Yes, it is. He's trying to get back involved as well.
Lindsay? Lindsay was just in... I mean, there's
Hefford's
nothing
got damage. Hefford's out.
Hefford's pulled off there. He's, oh, dear. Sometimes you've just got to laugh, haven't you, really? Let's have a little look and see. Hackerson into Janowski there. That's the way to get through. It's one way at least.
Oh no!
And
that's
Simpson and Janowski, and yes.
Oh, he forces him off, and that's going to allow Lindsay to have a go.
Oh, these Simpsons are crazy.
Up to the top of the hill then. Lindsay is through, is he? They nearly get stuck together again over the top of the hill, hard on the brakes. And Lindsay is just through. And Nick McCarron hits him and gets taken out by, who was that? That was Rob Fagg.
Oh, no, what happened there? I didn't even see what happened to poor old McCarron there. He's in the background. Oh, yeah, Janowski was hit quite well. And then McCarron was hit into by Nathaniel Simpson.
Side by side then, Kip Stevens and David Baker. Baker on the move. He's up to seventh place now, and he's just got past Kip Stevens over the line. And that's another position gained for the Season 7 champion.
So it was Rob Fagg, wasn't it? Karen, not Nathaniel Simpson, apologies.
And look at this. Battle at the front. Laura Bond, Philip Johansson, Andreas Katz. Look how close this is all of a sudden. We've got just under three laps to go.
Oh, and Johansson, his life flashed before his eyes there, because Bond just cut across the Swedish man there. Down the inside. Look at Andreas Katz there. Suddenly, I was said to you earlier on, Adam, that Andreas Katz seemed to be very quiet in this race meeting. He's come to life over the past few laps. Did Laura Bond have a mistake? Because she must have done, because she had a 129.2, which was 1.8 seconds slower than the previous lap. So Bond was cruising along with a 2-second lead, and now she finds herself with Season 8 champion behind.
Well, this
all
is
Adam's fault.
Here we go then. Kat's going to go down the inside into the penultimate corner. He's not wasting any time here.
He's not, but that's not really the place to make a move, because you always know that goodness me! That's a blown engine for
Laura Bond.
Laura Bond.
Dear me.
Oh,
just sack me now.
There.
Literally sack me now.
Absolute disaster, and that's disappointment there for Laura Bond. That could have been the first win.
Well, here we go then. Johansson trying to get past. Johansson under pressure gets hit a bit by Smolenski.
I'm guessing that. I mean, I don't know if it's possible. I'm guessing Bond that must have made a gear change just as she got hit, and possibly might have possibly overrevved the engine. Alex, is that something that could potentially happen? Or
Yeah, I mean, I can only imagine that's what it could have been. There wasn't enough contact there for it to have been, you know, damage-related or anything like that. So, yeah, really surprised.
I thought it was
Katz's engine at first, actually.
Was Katz trying to, like, do a dummy or something? Because he was going around the outside, then tried to cut back to the inside and unfortunately just hit.
Misjudged it a bit, didn't he? And it went badly, but it went well for him. Because actually he's in the... Oh, he's off now. Oh, gosh. I'm going to stop saying anything good about anybody, I think. Because Katz just went off the track.
See if Johansson's got anything for him.
You know, I think he could do. Johansson looked fairly quick in this race. I mean,
Simpson and Hackerson.
That sounds like a recipe for disaster.
Disaster. It could be a recipe for donuts, actually, as well.
Indeed, because... and look at them all here. Paul Smith. 3D
leading ones
this
as well.
Yeah, this
virtual
is
ones.
Virtual reality donuts, that's the one. They are 360 degrees, it is a circle. So, you know, we're getting somewhere with this. I'll tell you what. Oh, and there's not a straight gear Optima in this race, is there? I don't think. All sorts of trouble going on. Is that Richard Gore and Lee Berridge again?
Oh, who was that? That was Smolensky giving Johansson a little love tap there as well on the exit of turn two.
Oh, nice to see we found Alex Smolensky. He seems to have been pretty anonymous tonight, but he's there in third place. He's actually looking to try and get through on Johansson then.
Last lap of the race.
Yeah. Smolensky's going to be one to watch again, I think, come the Pro Series.
Yeah, he all of a sudden came out of nowhere, really, in the showdown, and up until about the final race meeting, had a great opportunity to possibly take a championship, just didn't work out at Daytona, but now he's trying to take the second place away from Johansson. Look how close he was there through that left-hand kink, up to the top of the hill. Whoa. This is going to be interesting here. Johansson's covering the inside line, both legs on the brakes.
It's only so late you can... Oh,
he hits him.
It's only so late you can break into the corkscrew. Just the nature of the corner, very, very tight apex.
And now it's going to be Kraft and Field.
Yeah, Kraft and Field to the line, but Andreas Katz has driven pretty well. Didn't have that coming together with Laura Bond, but the season, now then, am I going to get this right? 3-8 champion, Adam,
correct,
is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
The season 3-8 champion comes through and wins round 7 of the Winter Series by just about a second from Philip Johansson. And then it's Alexander Smolensky, Dan Kraft, and Simon Field with Dave Baker in 6th. Way! Kip Stevens in 7th. Lee Berridge 8th, 9th for Richard Gore. And 10th for Dylan Robinson. Adam, that was a crazy old race.
Yeah, I did say that grid, that top 10 would definitely create some excitement. And we did have 3 cars finishing inside the top 10 that started inside the top 10 in that one. So, yeah.
Great well racing. To them. The minority.
Yeah, the minority. Poor Laura Bond, though. I'm sure she'll take a victory at some point. Probably when we're not commentating on her.
Just with a couple of laps to go as well, that one. But,
yeah.
Alex, who's going to be the man on pole position then? Because it's not going to be Laura Bond because she's 28th, unfortunately. Could it be Mr. Rizzo?
It could be. Just having a look who is. who could be as the results flip up on the screen.
Let's have a look. Katz then won. He was fastest in practice as well, so that's pretty ominous there. And I think he was either second or third in race two as well. So he won. Philip Johansson second, Smolensky third, Kraft fourth, Field fifth, Baker in sixth, seventh Kip Stevens, eighth Berridge, ninth Gore, and then 10th Robinson, 11th Paul Smith, 12th for Posicek, 13th for Kaiser, 14th for Nathaniel Simpson, 15th for Hackerson, 16th Pete Newman, 17th Janowski, 18th Jay Wright, 19th Robbie Lindsay, 20th is Rob Plumley, 21st Nick McCarron, 22nd Max Wright, 23rd Jason Rowe, 24th Craig McLeod Evans, 25th Rick Scott, 26th John Roberts, and then the cars one lap down or more. 27th Rob Fagg, 28th Laura Bond, 29th Steve Hefford, 30th Steve Richardson from pole, 31st Andrew Whitehead, 32nd Colin Cunniff, 33rd Jamie Fluke, 34th George Simmons, 35th Robert Graham, and then 36 Cesar Rizzo. So Alex, who's going to get what it looks like to be the kiss of death and be on pole position for the fourth and final race of the evening?
Let's take it away. 19th was where it was from the last race.
Could it be the fall?
Who's going to get it? Oh, no, it's not going to be the fall. It's completely the other side of the wheel. It's going to be a large one though. 24th. Yeah, 24.
Oh, Craig McLeod Evans then.
Yeah, he's on to pole position there with Jason Rowe second, Max Wright third, Nick McKerron fourth, and Rob Plumley in fifth. So we've got some newcomers to the series right at the front of this pack for this fourth and final race.
And just as I did that time, I ended up on pole position via the reverse grid. It scared the life out of me, so good luck to those boys, I think. Right, thanks for joining us again for race three here on Motors TV. And we'll be back for the fourth and final round of the evening from Laguna Seca, just to the other side of this break. We'll see you then. The final race of the evening and of the British Sim Racers Touring Car Winter Series, brought to you here on Motors TV with Andrew Woodhouse, Adam Bath and Alex Simpson in the commentary box for you. Now Adam, we've had three races in the evening, and usually that's all we usually have for everybody to see, but we've got a fourth one of course in this Winter Series, and it's going to be a very, very interesting one indeed, because there's quite a few newcomers at the front of this reverse grid lineup.
Yeah, well, we thought third races were crazy. Then we saw what happened when we added a fourth one to the mix at Brands Hatch last week, and it was just pandemonium. And I think we only had about half the cars finishing out of the 38 that started there. So we'll see what happens this time around. And we were saying just before we came on air, the marbles have definitely increased for this fourth race. And so drivers that thought they could get a move done round the outside on those opening few corners definitely will be in for a shock. One in just a few moments of time. We'll look at the starting grid then, which is just about to pop up on our starting screen now.
Any second now.
There we go. And it is, yeah, there we go. Craig McLeod Evans on pole position, Jason Rowe in second, Max Wright third, Nick McKerron in fourth, Rob Plumley in fifth, Robbie Lindsay in sixth, Jay Wright seventh, Julian Janowski eighth, Pete Newman in ninth, and Ben Hackerson in tenth. And I couldn't think of a more open top ten. Any one of those drivers could take a victory there.
It's anybody's. I mean, I was racing with Jay Wright the other night, he looked pretty quick around Brands Hatch, but this is a bit of a different task, of course. Of course, Adam, the marbles accumulating over the 3-4 races as well, so that's why we're seeing such track evolution. Alex, have you got anybody you think could win this race? I mean, for me, Ben Hackerson and Pete Newman possibly are the main favourites here.
Yeah, I think you'd have to put those with great opportunity.
We just hope nobody stalls on the grid.
Well, yeah, that's it.
Because we had that at Brands Hatch, Adam, didn't we, with Newman?
Oh, yeah.
So,
here we go,
just
then.
About ready then. Red lights are going to come on.
Green, green, green.
And then we see the green light. Fantastic start by McLeod Evans. Wonderful. Off the front row, he's away and clear. McKerron's trying to get past Jason Rowe into the first corner. Let's see who's going to be braver on the brakes. Because remember, cold tyres and marbles, gentlemen, you need to be careful. As everyone...
McKerron's going for it.
Oh, McKerron's gone freeze on the marbles. And Plumley. Is everybody through? It looks like they are. Look at that.
Whoa. McLeod Evans all over the place. And now they're all cutting. They're all cutting the course.
Wright and Smith, I think, off.
Oh, Richard Gore's off.
Gore's in the wall. Oh, no, and a Powermax car going off there. It's causing all sorts of trouble.
Oh, Bond.
Bond's coming back on with a dangerous rejoin, hitting a Laser Tools car. And I think that could potentially be a penalty, similar to the one that possibly should have been had earlier on.
Cloud Evans then leading to the top of the hill for the corkscrew for the first time. McKerron in second place. We'll see how long the Scotsman's going to be able to hold on to the lead for. Robert Plumley in third as well. So McKerron and Plumley chasing him down already. And it's Newman, Lindsay, Janowski. Oh, crash at the back, and Kraft is rejoining. We've got a car facing backwards. And
McLeod Evans.
It's Jerome Kaiser and Rob Faggers off as well. And yeah, McLeod Evans is off.
Was off, but he's managed to get a nice exit out of the last corner. Alex, we've never seen a more Scottish car in the BSRTC. It's even got Iron Brew on the front.
Yeah, I know, perfect. I just want to play the advert.
The advert, yeah.
The Wembley advert with the dog and everything now, though.
He's off! Oh, he's off as well!
He's back on!
Is he back on?
He's lost the lead, though.
Oh, the marbles are such there, Adam, in all seriousness.
I'm hearing something major!
What on earth is that? Was that blown? A field is gone? Rick Scott is off.
Let's
have a look.
It was Field and possibly, is that Rizzo?
It's my
Field,
word.
Field of Rizzo and
Rick Scott. Oh, it starts in front of them.
Oh,
I'm just scrolling
Simpson
forward.
And, good lord almighty. And how Jerome Kaiser got through there is anyone's guess.
Right, so Field's going down, minding his own business, but they have to pass that lap. I mean, that's slowing down. Who is that slowing down? Hefford. They're slowing down Hefford, and then it just causes madness.
And Hefford, of course, is the only one who doesn't get hit. So, fair play to Steve Hefford there.
Right.
But we've got McKerrin in the... Oh, McLeod Evans off again, and he's had trouble with that second to last corner. Pete Newman's going to try and get the cut back then. And no. Not this time. See the marbles flying off the tyres of these Kia Optima. Dave Baker's off at the final corner.
Newman then trying to get past McLeod Evans then over the top of the hill through this left-hander. Down the inside he goes, late on the brakes.
Is he late enough?
Just. I think he's going to be clear for turn two. Yes, he is.
And McLeod Evans learns his lesson from the previous lap and does not venture out onto the marbles, onto the dirty part of the track, but he's got a nice run. McLeod Evans there, but there's no overtaking place through this first sector.
Lindsay and Janowski battling as well. These two over fifth and sixth. Janowski started in eighth position, so again, two spots already.
Janowski, whose race meeting doesn't seem to be complete ever without hitting Rob Fagg. Rob Fagg's out, actually, isn't he? So Paul Smith is out as well, and well, that's like it's like Sean Bean dying in a TV show. It's inevitable, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, indeed. Lindsay there closing onto the back of McLeod Evans. Paul sitting now down into fourth place. Nick McKerrin leading by 0.6 of a second over Rob Plumley.
We haven't seen Nick McKerrin in the lead of a race for a long time, Adam. I don't think. Can you remember the last time? I'm not sure.
Adam, I'm not sure. Noel Johansson battling away with Potacek. And he's through, and so is David Baker.
Oh, look at that last of the late breakers up the inside. Who's that? That's Andreas Katz. Having a little look on Dave Baker and on Philip Johansson. So, and Johansson's been very impressive, Adam. And it does look like if he does come into the Club Series, that he's into the Pro Series, sorry, from the Club Series, that he's going to be a bit of a threat going forward.
Yeah, he's definitely shown a potential in these four races tonight, and he's doing it. So once again, battling away with David Baker. This is over 9th and 10th, and Katz is going to shove it down the inside there as well. Nearly gets it done.
It's very, very difficult to pass there, though, mate. As you know, it's a very tricky corner at the best of times, but it's really one line, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. And well, if you try and get it done down the inside there, it's almost certain that the car on the outside is going to get you back before that right-hander. And Baker there trying to get past, no way through. I saw a car going side by side in front, and that was Lindsay and Janowski still battling away, but they've not been able to source each other out.
And Janowski saw his braking out of the corkscrew. The answer is yes, he can this time. So, feeling Janowski there, no doubt having flashbacks of the incident with
Rob Fagg, yeah.
Two incidents apparently with Rob Fagg. I think there's one in the second race as well. So, good defence by Lindsay. He's not backing down from
He's off.
Julian Janowski.
And Posicek's off. Johansson, he's off. He's going to come back on, but that's going to force Baker off.
Baker's off as well, and it just shows how easy. Alex, it just shows how easy it is when the track's dirty that you can just get offline and that's it.
Yeah, just no way back for Baker. He just had to run that little bit wide there. He's got Katz to worry about now as well. Katz up the inside. Baker will get a better run unless Johansson's on the money as well. He's pretty even, so Baker, you'd think... Oh, no. Katz just sweeps around the outside and shuts the door.
He didn't quite get it turned around the centre of the double apex left-hander, Adam, did he?
Baker. Yeah. Tasty a bit further up the road as well, between Lindsay Kraft. And Kraft. Oh.
Yep. Yeah, they're both, they just hit each other.
Yeah. It's a right on cue, Alex, as usual.
And now McLeod Evans continuing to having to withstand pressure from Janowski. We'll see if Janowski can get it done now. Up the top of the hill, named after Bobby Rahal, I do believe. And down the inside, he's off, he's on the marbles, and they're both going to go off, I think.
Oh, Janowski McLeod stops Evans is off. Oh, well, that's got to be suspension damage, isn't it?
Oh, well. Oh, and Smolenski and Robinson, sorry, hits
McLeod
him.
McLeod Evans is off in the middle as well. And
forced off by Robinson.
Scottish on Scottish finalists.
Oh, he hits Janowski. Janowski's around. And hits Lindsay. And he's over. And Johansson's going to get turned. And hits, who's that? That is Andreas Katz.
Oh, Lindsay's back on.
The M25, a rush out.
Were you stuck in this kind of traffic? Is it these idiots that cause those traffic jams you keep getting stuck in?
This is it.
So, Smolenski on the inside then. Into the first corner with Johansson. Smolenski showed, it wasn't Smolenski, was it? It was the other laser tools
Robinson,
car.
Robinson, yeah.
Of Robinson, who showed absolutely no mercy to the other car carrying the Soul Tyre.
Oh, so, down the inside.
Ooh.
And that's Johansson back through. And Pete Newman's just got past Rob Plumley for second place, so that's happening further up.
We do have to point out to all new viewers of the series that this is both infrequent and often.
as Robinson and Katz go wheel to wheel again.
But these guys letting their hair down a little bit. They had a long pro series which lasted for 8 months, and it's a bit of a friendly competition. It's still very competitive, of course, here, but a little bit more violent than usual, Adam, I think.
Yeah, I think so. And with this four race format, we're always asking for stuff like this come the end of the evening, of course. But three serious races.
You've got less time, haven't you, to make your way through?
Yes, indeed, only 10 laps. Equating to how about a 20-minute race or so?
Yeah, about 15 on this track, yeah. I think. But it definitely does, widen the senses a little bit. It definitely forces you to make moves, I think, when you ordinarily wouldn't do. I think that's both a good and a bad thing. Is Nick McCarron now, good thing for him, he's still in the lead. Bad thing for him, Adam, he's got Pete Newman all over the back of him. His mirrors will be full of blue and yellow.
Yeah, definitely. And four laps to go. Craig McLeod Evans, by the way, is out of the race. I think he's either in the pits or has got some problems. So the pole sitter, as it seems to be, race two, race three, and race four. I think the pole sitter has ended up being out of the race. But here comes Pete Newman. Just had to do a little bit of defending there. Pete Newman just starting to eye him up a bit. And he's very close to him now. 3.5 laps to go here in his fourth and final race, moving across just a little bit there. McCarron, I don't know whether he's going to get the best run on the exit. It's going to be close. But Pete Newman's going to get a run up towards the corkscrew.
George Simmons is having a fantastic race as well, off camera, 34th on the grid to 10th as we watch this battle for the lead. And it's raging between McCarron and Newman. Where's the most likely place, Alex, for Newman to get this move done if he does?
Yeah, you have to think turn one's going to be the chance, so maybe into the final turn as well. But
here we go. Is he going
to? Yeah, usually you set this up to get that move into turn one. See the wide line, get on the power just a little bit earlier, tucked into the draft already
he's hit him,
as well.
I think.
Definitely going to be side by side going into turn one.
There's a little bit of contact there, Adam, but he does have the slipstream, Newman, but it's forced slightly wide on that crest. And wow. Newman down the inside. That's a lovely. Banging wheel arches there. Lovely move by Newman, and he really did force the issue with McCarron there.
Fantastic move, and yeah, Newman now into the race lead. We'll see what Robert Plumley can now do, see if he can get past Nick McCarron. Didn't get the best run through there, McCarron, in fact, and Plumley's now right with him through these corners. I wonder if the tyres are just starting to give up. We are entering the closing stages of the race.
Well, it was a forceful move by Pete Newman, but to be honest, McCarron, he left the door open, Alex, and he paid for it.
Yeah, exactly. I think you could always see that Pete was going to try and squeeze down that inside if he had half an opportunity. And Nick just started to move over a little early. He just needed to wait, sort of 10 metres or so. And I would have thought Pete would have gone, maybe next lap.
Of course, McCarron.
That's going to be slow down.
Oh,
maybe.
plummeting around the outside.
No, it's not.
Oh, not yet anyway.
Back down the inside. Oh, they nearly get stuck together and plummeting into second now.
Indeed, and McKerrin's still third though. If he hangs on to that, it's still a very good result for him. He's still higher than he started. He started fourth, and he's in third currently. Dan Craft is in fourth, but he's actually got Andreas Katz at him for company. And we know both these men race winners. Both these men very quick. It's going to be a good fight. And Baker and Simmons, yes. Simmons has had a phenomenal race. Actually, he's carving through the field and that black and pink car, and trying to carve his way past Baker, Adam.
Looks like we lost Adam, actually.
We've lost Adam for
some technical issues.
That's not unusual tonight, is it, really?
No, it's just been one of those nights, I tell you.
Simmons has had a fantastic race, and he's now right behind Baker, and Baker is defending for everything he's got, and he's doing a grand job of actually staying in front of George Simmons. So having Simmons being ahead of him over the line, and he's all over the back of him. This is obviously we don't really know much about George Simmons, Alex, but his pace is astonishing at times.
It's been very quick tonight, actually. You know, he got caught up in an accident in the third race, was it? So, otherwise, I think he'd been right up there in that one as well. But
getting harder to figure out which race people have crashed in as well. However, we've got four of them, but Jamie Fluke has now caught up to the back of Steve Hefford as well. That's it. Just shows, Alex, a bad race two for Jamie Fluke, and bad race three for Jamie Fluke, and you know, he hasn't really been seen since.
Yeah, exactly. Struggled. I think we've seen that, you know, time and time again. You know, you have one bad race and it actually just really affects your meet, and it's worse now as well because you're all the way back. Although, if you get a bad race too, you've got a chance to recover and get a reasonable reverse grid place. So, you know, I think that will play into some of the drivers' favour when we come to the Pro Series anyway.
Yeah, when people have been close naturally, when people have been naturally a little bit more careful, I think as well. Oh yeah, as we've got Robinson, Johansson, Smolensky, Baker and Simmons all in a line as it's the final lap, and the final lap for Pete Newman. But we're going to have a little look at this battle as they head up towards the corkscrew, and we're going to see if anybody decides to make a move. Or Robinson, very wide, but you can get away with it at that point. It's pretty slow up towards the corkscrew. Let's see. Simmons going down the inside, is he? No. Hackerson on the back of this train as well. But it's going to be into the final corner then for the last time. Oh, as McKerrin goes off in the background, but it's Pete Newman who rounds the final corner. And Pete Newman's going to take his first win in quite some time as he wins at Laguna Seca in round four of the evening. Great second place for Plumlee, great third place for McKerrin. And Andreas Katz once again came alive in the later stages of the race to finish fourth.
I think Simmons got Baker on the line there.
He did indeed. Hackerson got Smolensky by 1/100th of a second as well. So to round up the results for round four of the evening here at Laguna Seca, Pete Newman winning by 3 seconds from Robert Plumlee, and then it's Nick McKerrin in third, Andreas Katz fourth, Daniel Kraft fifth, Dylan Robinson sixth ahead of Philip Johansson, and then George Simmons in eighth from 34th on the grid, a tremendous effort. Dave Baker in 9th and Ben Hackerson in 10th. Adam, are you back? We got him?
No, he's still not back, unfortunately.
Still not back. So,
technical problems are us tonight, unfortunately.
Technical problems are us, I think.
Well, hopefully, those that missed the early parts of the streams, we cut into two parts. There's obviously a lot of chat going on there and things like that. So I'll try and edit them up very, very quickly, and we'll get them up and able for people to watch as soon as possible. But hopefully we'll have some other recorded footage that we might be able to use if none of it turns out to work.
All right. Well, Alex, Adam, it's been an absolutely great meeting here tonight at Laguna Seca. It's been lots of fun. And from all of us here on Motors TV, and Apex Racing TV. We're going to see you next week for more BSRTC Winter Series.